This is a hypersonic missile that's been developed by the US military, with research that goes back about 7 decades. The goal is to reach at least 5 times the speed of sound and easily change course while in the air. And this is China's first known model. The relative newcomer to the technology unveiled the weapon in 2019. This type of missile is regarded as one of the most advanced military tools in existence and a hard-to-detect weapon that current defense systems struggle to take down. So we compare the differences in the US and China's designs as the race to add hypersonic missiles to their arsenals changes the global balance of military power. To get a sense of why hypersonic weapons can be so deadly, you first need to know the 2 main categories of existing missiles. Most cruise missiles travel in the atmosphere between 400 to 600 miles per hour and are maneuverable. But because they fly relatively slow and low to the ground, radars can detect the missiles and defense systems can shoot them down. Ballistic missiles, on the other hand, travel a lot faster because they rely on rockets that launch them into space. But they follow a predetermined and arched trajectory, so defense systems are able to predict and intercept them. The hypersonic missile, on the other hand, addresses shortcomings with both of those classes of missiles.
The speed and maneuverability of hypersonic weapons allows them to evade defenses.
Brian Clark is a senior fellow at the Hudson Institute, a right-leaning policy think tank based in Washington, D.C. He's a retired U.S. Navy submariner and has been studying military technology for more than 20 years.
If you're trying to defend against a hypersonic weapon, you have to put up with both the speed of the weapon, which is higher than cruise missiles, and also it's unpredictable, which is different than ballistic missiles.
The U.S. has been trying to work on this combination of speed and maneuverability since the mid-1950s. One of the first was developed during the Cold War, and it could carry a nuclear warhead. But Clark says developing this type of weapon became a lower priority after the Cold War, as nuclear threats diminished in the 1990s. However, the calculus changed after the September 11th terrorist attacks. Adding to that, countries like North Korea and Iran have been ramping up the development of missiles and nuclear technology. Plus, China was also quickly growing its own military capabilities.
This led some Pentagon thinkers to propose the idea of a weapon that could allow the U.S. military to quickly strike some threats.
Timothy Heath is a senior researcher at RAND Corporation, a nonprofit that contributes strategic analysis to the U.S. Department of Defense. He's been studying China's military strategy for more than 20 years. Though it's hard to know Beijing's exact motivations for looking into hypersonic missiles, Heath says the leadership's interest was piqued in part by the growing discussions of such weapons in the U.S., as well as concerns that the country didn't have enough deterrence against its rivals' weapons capabilities. So China has moved quickly.
China's hypersonic weapon has not just been successfully tested, it has been proved for production and has been produced and has been deployed to units.
And that weapon is the DF-17 missile. DF stands for Dongfang, or East Wind in Chinese. This is what the Pentagon says will be the United States' first hypersonic weapon. ARRW stands for Air-Launched Rapid Response Weapon. And following several test failures, U.S. officials said it wouldn't be operational until next year. Both China's and America's missiles have the same 2 parts. A booster rocket and, perched on top, a hypersonic glide vehicle which holds the warhead. But they're launched differently. China's DF-17 missile is launched from the ground. A truck carries a single missile, then elevates it to point up at the sky. The booster rocket then launches it into the near space atmosphere and releases the hypersonic glide vehicle. China says it can reach a maximum speed of more than 7,000 miles per hour as it heads towards the target. The ARRW missile works similarly, but it's carried by a bomber plane which drops the weapon in mid-air. Then the missile uses its own rocket to fly to a higher altitude, and the hypersonic glide vehicle breaks off from the booster and glides down to carry out the strike. The Air Force says it can reach a maximum speed of more than 15,000 miles per hour, or 20 times the speed of sound. Defense analysts say the differences in the 2 launch systems largely come down to how the U.S. and China want to use these weapons.
The U.S. has global interests and is looking for a way to strike targets around much of the world. Therefore, an air launch platform makes the most sense.
So the U.S. has said it's going to equip the missiles with conventional warheads. He says China, however, is focusing more on threats around the country's periphery.
They're still focused on missions like Taiwan, defeating adversaries in the South China Sea. What they need are sufficient numbers of munitions deployed along China's border to carry out a mission when ordered.
And when deployed, the U.S. Defense Department says China could use a nuclear warhead. China's State Council Information Office didn't respond to a request for comment. But before these weapons can be fully operational on the battlefield, testing is key. Because at hypersonic speeds, heat builds up around the missile and air molecules also start to change. And all this can block electromagnetic signals.
If you want the hypersonic glide vehicle to be able to hit a moving target, then you need to have a radar or a camera, you know, seeker that's able to survive in those kinds of environments. So you need to have a wind tunnel that's able to create the kinds of speeds necessary.
And that's one area where China may have an edge over the U.S. In 2017, China revealed what it said is the world's largest wind tunnel capable of testing a full-size hypersonic missile. It's also building a brand new tunnel that will be able to simulate flights at 30 times the speed of sound, according to the country's top scientific think tank. However, the U.S. has been saddled with aging tunnels. Most of the existing ones were built between the 1950s and 1970s. Military experts say that China is leading the way in development, so the U.S. has made it one of its top priorities to deploy these weapons.
Our own pursuit of hypersonic capabilities is real. It's tangible.
This year, the Pentagon requested $3.8 billion as part of its budget for its hypersonic weapons program. That's almost 20% more than last year. And the U.S. military is also working on other advanced hypersonic capabilities. Several research institutions are also building new wind tunnels. But staying ahead of its rival may mean the U.S. needs to focus more on defense and how to stop a Chinese hypersonic missile.
If you can build a missile against which there's no defense, China could deploy this as a way to deter or intimidate any of its neighbors or even the U.S. In the event of a crisis.
China is expanding its arsenal not just with hypersonic missiles, but other military technology. And if Washington feels like it needs to match China's capabilities, defense analysts say the U.S. will need to work vigilantly to defend against any potential threats from its rival.